Hanna Mansdotter was born on December 28, 1841 in Sweden. She grew up in the countryside within the city of Kristianstad. Her family did not have much money, so they thought the best option would be for her to marry into money. She was fairly young when she married a successful farmer by the name of Nils Nilsson. Nils owned his own farm in Yingstjo, and after marrying, Anna moved on to the farm with him. Nils was 10 or 13 years older than Anna, and she assumed he had everything in order and that they would be rich. She soon learned otherwise. They had very strict living conditions, and Anna was not happy. They had 3 children together, but 2 had died young, and only 1 son by the name of Per, who was born in 1863, had made it to adulthood.
Fader vår som i himlen, helgat var ditt namn. Tillkomme ditt rike, ske din vilje, så som i himmelen, så och på jorden. Vårt dagliga bröd.
Life was rough, and it got harder when Nils got sick and ended up passing away in 1883. Anna was in her early 40s and Per was now 20 years old. Anna and Per were alone and only had each other for moral support. Their relationship developed into something more, and they soon started a sexual relationship. Their relationship was getting serious, so Anna thought to have Per get married as to divert the attention from them to his new relationship. So Per began courting a young woman by the name of Hanna Johansdotter. She and her family lived in the neighboring village called Brosarp, and they believed with Per inheriting his father's farm, their daughter would be comfortable, protected, and supported. Hanna's father was well respected in the community and worked as a chief district judge, so Hanna thought if she ever needed her father for anything, he would be able to support her with no issues. Before marrying, the initial plan was for Per to move in with her at her house so she could be with her mother. After the wedding, Per had other plans and requested that Hanna come move onto the farm with him and his mother. Hanna quickly found out that she was unhappy in the marriage, was in a place she did not want to be, and her mother-in-law was taking quality time away from her and her new husband. Anna ended up pleading to her father to help and explained to him that she was having issues in her marriage all because of Per's mother. Hannah's father ignored her pleas, believing it was just a mother loving her son, so Hanna was left with no one to support or listen to her cries for help. Anna and Per, on the other hand, were all ears. Hannah's complaints made them nervous, and they thought that their relationship would become public knowledge. They were paranoid that they had been caught, so they felt that their only option was to kill Hanna. On the fatal night of March 28, 1889, Anna and Per were ready to follow through with their plan. Hanna was beat with a piece of wood, and then she was redressed and placed at the bottom of a staircase to make it appear as if she had accidentally fallen and hurt herself. Hanna was only 22 years old when she was killed. When authorities found the body, they knew it was not an accidental fall and was most likely a murder case. Anna and Per were both charged and gave multiple accounts of what happened. During trial, they were both tried together, and everyone was made aware of the fact that they had a romantic relationship, so prosecutors went with the jealousy angle as reason for the murder. Per and Anna were both found guilty and sentenced to death. Anna was set to die on August 6, 1890, and was led to her death at 8 o'clock in the morning. She wore a beautiful white dress, and many mentioned that it looked like she was dressed up for a fancy party. She was said to be executed by axe, and she died fairly quickly. Her body was used for scientific research, and an artist was able to use her face to make a death mask that was eventually displayed at the Wax Museum in Stockholm. Anna was the very last woman to be executed in Sweden. As for Per, some believed that Anna did the killing and he just gave her permission, and some believed Anna took matters into her own hands and acted alone. Per was eventually pardoned, and his sentence was changed to life of hard labor. In 1913, he was released for unknown reasons, and just 5 years after his release, he died from tuberculosis. Thank you guys for watching another episode of Death Row Executions. And if you like this story, please give the video a like for me and leave a comment in the comment section below.